Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are doing very fine and welcome to my YouTube channel. So I expect that you have seen all the last 8 videos of this chapter. Today is the last day of this chapter, and so today we will discuss the question answers. All the theory part we have covered. We have discussed the force, the moment of force, the turning effect. After that we went to pressure, then the pressure due to solid, the factors affecting the pressure due to solid, then the pressure due to liquid, and at last the atmospheric pressure. So we have discussed the theory part. So today we will discuss some of the question answers, and specially I will give focus on the numericals, because that is the part which all of you happen to hate or happen to ignore. And for your future, doing numericals is very important. Your base becomes very strong even in the higher classes. Numericals are the most important part, so focus on the numericals. Even in one teacher told me, if students happens to, like when I was also a student of your age that time, my teacher told me, if you focus on the numericals, the theory becomes easier for you. You do more numericals, the theory, somewhere it becomes easier for you. You just understand the theory by itself only, by doing more and more numericals. So today we will do the numericals, but before that I'll just discuss few of the reasoning questions. See, most of the questions, that 41 questions which are given in the back of your book, all maximum 90% of the questions I have discussed while I was in all the previous 8 lectures. I have discussed all those questions. If you follow all my previous eight lectures, you see the questions one by one, in all the questions have been answered in all the previous videos. So like, for example, there was a question like, why the spanner, the length of the spanner is big. I think I explained that in one of the videos. If the length of the spanner becomes big, then the perpendicular distance becomes big. If perpendicular distance becomes big, more, then what happens? The force that we are applying becomes less. So we apply less force and we get the turning effect. So most of the questions answers have been discussed. Few of them are left which I will discuss. Now coming to this question, I think this question is question number 25 of your book. See this question, which is very easy, but try to understand the concept of it. A gum bottle means Fevicol or something like that. A gum bottle rests on the base. So this is, suppose this is the base. Rest on the base. If it is placed upside down. Now what I am doing, this gum bottle I am placing upside down. Matlab ulta. If I do it opposite, then see, I'm drawing it, trying to draw actually, opposite. Then, this is the same gum bottle, I don't know how to write. Gum, see, opposite. I have turned the bottle upside down. Now, if I turn the bottle upside down, how it will affect the thrust and the pressure? So let's first focus on this part, thrust. If you have understood all the previous videos, what is thrust? Thrust is nothing but perpendicular force. So it is nothing but a perpendicular force or force. And what is this perpendicular force? Is nothing but the weight of the body. So what is thrust? A perpendicular force. And this perpendicular force which the body gives, how the body gives? Because the body has its own weight, because of this own weight only, it can give a perpendicular force. And that perpendicular force is called as thrust. Now think, it's basically thinking. This is the marker. Suppose this marker has a weight of say for example, 2 newtons. This marker weighs 2 newton. If I turn upside down like this, does it become 5 newton or does it become 1 newton? Means if I turn the this way, it is 2 newton. If I turn the marker upside down, does the weight increases or the weight decreases? Does that happen? No, the weight remains. if it like this, if it is 2 Newton, this way also it's 2 Newton only. So thrust is nothing but the weight. See, if I turn upside down, then what will happen? If the thrust right now, which is giving, suppose it is giving you 5 Newton, opposite way, if I, that will also give you 5 Newton of thrust only. That will not give you 6 Newton. So what happens? In the first part, I can say what? Thrust remains same. Thrust remains same. Clear to you? Thrust remains same. Now, if you understood, now I come to the second part. Now my second part says, what about the pressure? What about the pressure? Now see, now over here something happens. This area is more or not? This area is more. Suppose I consider the area as 5 meter square. And this area is less, means what? The area which is in contact with the ground. The area of the bottle which is in contact with the ground is less. So suppose I consider this as 2 meter square, right? These are the two areas. What is the force? Say I am considering the force that this bottle is giving. Suppose over here the bottle is giving a force of 20 Newton. And if I turn it upside down, then also gives a force of 20 Newton. In both the ways, gives a force of 20 Newton. Now see, what is the pressure in this situation? Pressure in the situation 1 is force by area or thrust by area, whatever. So 20 Newton by 5 meter square. It becomes how much? 4 Newton per meter square or 4 Pascal. And the second situation, force by area. No, sorry. This becomes area, area 2. Force by area. So the force remains same, 20 Newton only, upside down. But now the area is how much? 2 meter square. So how much it is? 10 Newton per meter square. So over here, the pressure is how much? 4 Pascals. And over here, the force is how much? 10 Pascals. See, the first situation, it is 4. And the second situation, it is 10. So if I happen to turn my gum bottle upside down, what happens to the pressure? The pressure suddenly happens to increase. The pressure suddenly increases. So I think you understood the part. It's a normal common sense that over here area is more, pressure will be less. Over here area is less, pressure becomes more. So as it is turned upside down, now it is the area which is in contact with the ground is less. So as area decreases, pressure becomes more. So this is a normal way. Now I come to the second part of the sum. Now there is a second question I want to do. I think this is question number 40. 40 part A. 40 part A. The question is there. A balloon is there. A balloon collapses as the air is removed. Suppose this is the balloon. This is the balloon. Okay. It is fully filled. Now, if I make a puncture, if I make a puncture over here, then what happens? As the air removes, goes out, the balloon collapses. The balloon just collapses. So the balloon collapses if the air is removed. Why? The balloon collapses if the air is removed. Question is why? Simple answer. Simple answer. Think. If the air is removed, if air is removed, what happens? If air is removed, air pressure, the air pressure also goes away. Air pressure is there because of air. If there is air, there is air pressure. If there is no air, there is no air pressure. So if I take all the air out, I am actually taking all the air pressure also out. I am taking all the air pressure out. So if the air goes out, so if the air is removed, what happens? The air pressure decreases. Actually, it becomes zero only. The air pressure decreases. And if the air pressure decreases, okay, so there, you do think the balloon will be in a like fully inflated form? No, the balloon will collapse. So as the air pressure decreases, the balloon collapses. Okay, so if the air is removed, the air pressure goes away. If the air pressure goes away, the balloon also collapses at the same time. So this is the answer. So why the balloon collapses? Because air pressure decreases. Okay. Now I think there is one more question. I think this is 40B. The question is something like this. The rubber bulb, if you press the rubber bulb, then the water comes out. Something like this, okay. When the rubber bulb is pressed, the water comes out. Question is, why? Something like this the question is. So take a dropper. You know what is a dropper? Sometimes if you have some infection in your eyes, then you take a dropper in your eyes. You happen to have a something like this. There is a something like this, and there is a ball. Okay, there is a ball and there is a liquid. There is a liquid. So firstly, this is the water. So what we do? We press this bulb. This is the bulb. If we press this bulb, then the water comes out. Why? This was the question. Think. What is there inside the bulb? Inside the bulb, there is nothing but air. Inside the bulb, there is nothing but air. So as I press the bulb, what happens? The air becomes compressed. As I press the bulb, air becomes compressed. Or I can say, as I press the bulb, the air pressure over here increases. So as the bulb is pressed, then what happens? Air pressure inside the bulb increases. So as the bulb is pressed, the air pressure inside the bulb happens to increase. And if this air pressure increases, this air pressure which is increased, okay, now this air pressure will try to push the liquid out. So the air pressure, and this air pressure which is now increased, will try to push the liquid out. So this air pressure forces the liquid to come out. So easy thing, as you press the bulb, the air pressure increases. As the air pressure increases, this pressure forces the liquid. Okay, this pressure forces the liquid to come out. It's similar to that that pichkari that you use in the Holi. As you press the syringe, okay, the air forces the liquid to come out of the pichkari, okay, that you enjoy in the holy time. So this is one reasoning question. So
So most of the reasoning question over here is because of air pressure only. Okay, tomorrow when you will open the dojo class, I have told, I have written over there, questions comes from air pressure. Many questions happens to come from the air pressure part. Now I will start with the numericals. Because most of the questions are all been discussed in the previous lecture. You see any question which is there, which I haven't discussed in any video lecture, you just see everything I've discussed. Now before I start with the question numericals, question answer means now numericals. One important thing. We have to know a little bit about conversion. Do you know this thing? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Do you know? I think you know because this is taught in class 4 or 5. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Now if I write 1 meter into 1 meter, can I say it is nothing but 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter? Can I say? Think. 1 meter into 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, 100 centimeter, because 1 is equal to 100. So 1 into 1 will be 100 into 100. Simple as that. Now 1 into 1 is how much? 1 and m into m, meter square. Okay, so I think in your maths exponent chapter has been taught, is getting taught. So that over there you will get idea that meter into meter is meter square. Okay, so I think Sir Arvind is saying the exponent chapter. So meter, as I over there use the concept of from that chapter, that meter into meter is meter square. And what is 100 into 100? Can I say 100 into 100 is nothing but 10,000? Think 2020, so 40. 100 into 100 is 10,000. And centimeter into centimeter is how much? Centimeter square. Centimeter into centimeter is centimeter square. Now this relation is a very important relation for this chapter, that 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square. 10,000 centimeter square. Why it is very important? I'll tell you. If 1 meter is equal to 10,000 centimeter square, can I write 10,000 centimeter square is equal to 1 meter square? Just opposite. A is equal to B, I've written B is equal to A. Same thing. Huh? The 10,000 centimeter square is equal to 1 meter square. What difference is there? Now, after this. So, therefore, if I talk about 1 centimeter square from here, how much is 1 centimeter square? 1 centimeter square is nothing but 1 by 10,000 meter square. Think. 1 meter square is 10,000 centimeter square. So, 1 centimeter square will be how much? This 1,000 will come down. So that 1 centimeter square is equal to 1 by 1000 meter square. And these two are very important relationship for the numerical point of view. Okay, these two are the very important two relationships for the numerical point of view. If you know, very good. If you don't know, no. Right now, you can also take a screenshot of this, because this will be utilized in mostly 90% of the sum, this will be utilized. Okay, over there, don't ask, sir, how you are getting the conversion. I think I made you understand. Okay, I'm repeating it once more. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So, 1 meter into 1 meter will be 100 centimeter to 100 centimeter. Therefore, 1 meter square is equal to 10,000. 100 into 100 is 10,000 centimeter square. So, if I know 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square, I change it. The 10,000 centimeter square is equal to 1 meter square. Just putting this thing over here and this over here. And from here, I know what? 1 centimeter square is equal to 1 by 10,000 meter square. So, 1 by 10,000 meter square. So, these two are the very important two relationship. Now, how this is important? I'm just explaining with one small question. Okay? One small question. This question is there in your book only. Suppose force is equal to 20 newton. In a question, my force is 20 newton. Force means what? The thrust. The force means thrust over here. And the area is given, suppose I am writing over here 5 centimeter square and they are asking me to calculate the pressure. So this is the question. Force, which is a thrust, okay, don't get confused, force and thrust means the same. So force is 20 newton, area is 5 centimeter square, pressure is how much? Now, I told you when I was doing numericals also, every numerical is related to a particular formula. Every numerical is related to a particular formula. So, over here, what formula it is related to? So, this question is related to what formula? Think. Force, area, pressure. Means what? Thrust, area, pressure. Thrust, area, pressure. Thrust, area, pressure is related to which formula? Only one formula that we have. That pressure is equal to thrust upon area. So this is one formula that we have. And another, okay, for the part pressure, for the moment of force, we had a different formula, but I'm not coming to that. So pressure is equal to thrust by area. Now if I use this formula, will I get the answer? See, if I'm doing the first the wrong way. If I do the wrong way, pressure is equal to a thrust by area. So thrust, you take it 20 newton. And area, you take it 5 centimeter square. And when you cancel it, you get 4 and newton per centimeter square. If you do your sum in this manner, then you will get a full negative, full zero. This is wrong. Okay, this is fully wrong. Now the question is, why it is wrong? Why this question came wrong, huh? Everything to well, okay. Pressure is thrust by area. So thrust by area, so this is 20 newton is thrust, 20 newton, area is 5 centimeter square, put 5, cancel 5 and 20 by 4 and newton per centimeter square. The problem over here is what I told you when I was doing the numericals of moment of force. All the questions, mostly all the questions on of physics is done in SI unit. So the numericals have to be done in their SI unit with the numericals have to be done in SI unit. Tell me, if 5 centimeter square, is this centimeter square is a SI unit? Huh? Centimeter square is a SI unit? Of course not. Meter square is a SI unit. So I have to call meter square is the SI unit of area. Area ka SI unit kya hota hai? Area ka SI unit hota hai meter square. But in the question is given centimeter square. So I have to do what? I have to convert this centimeter square into meter square. And how will I convert? For that only I taught you the previous method that 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square. Now over there I told you to take a screenshot, right? See the screenshot. I have written over there 1 centimeter square is equal to 1 by 10,000 meter square. This formula I have written. So 1 centimeter square is 1 by 10,000 meter square. But in a question, how much I have? 5. So 5 centimeter square will be how much? 5 by 10,000 meter square. Okay, 5 by 10,000 meter square. And now I can get my answer. So now I can get my answer that area was given as 5 centimeter square, which is nothing but 5 by 10,000 meter square. Now I have to find pressure. So pressure is equal to what? Pressure is nothing but force by area. Force by area or thrust by area. Now I can put force is what? 20 newton. SI unit. Newton is SI unit. So I don't need to change it. 20 newton. Now the area, I will take this as my area, not this one. So it becomes how much? 5 by 10,000 meter square. Now try to rearrange this thing. These are taught in maths and you will get your answer. 20, this 10,000 will come up and this 5 will come down. So if you cancel 4, so it becomes 40,000. 4 into 10,000 is 40,000 newton per meter square or pascal. Okay, 40,000 newton per meter square or pascal. So this is the correct way to do the sum. Have you understood? If you have understood, good. You can also take a screenshot of this sum. So because that might help you to do the other sums. So I want you to what to do? I want you to do this sum as a homework and write the answer in the comment section. Now I am changing my force to 40 Newton and the area that I have is say say I'm making the area as something like 8 centimeter square. So I want the answer to be written pressure. How much will be the pressure? So I want the answer to be written in the comment section. Clear? So this is the first homework I have given. Now let's continue. Now next question that I want to do. Now if what there are one question is given. Pressure is equal to 26500 Newton and area is given as 100 centimeter square. So this is one question given to you. See again, not Newton, it will be Pascal. So pressure is given and area is also given and they're asking you to find the force or the thrust, force or the perpendicular force or the thrust. So this is the question. So how to solve it? Again the same problem. See, area is given in what? Centimeter square. As you can see, the area is given in what? Centimeter square. This is not a SI unit, Baba. This is not a SI unit. Centimeter square is not a SI unit. So I have to convert the centimeter square into meter square. Only then I can solve the question. And how to solve it? How to go? Because we know a relation. 1 centimeter square is equal to 1 by 10,000. Meter square. This is a standard relationship between centimeter square and meter square. I told you that time, take a screenshot. Why I told you at that time, I think now you understood, because this relation will be utilized in each and every sum. So 1 centimeter square is 1 by 10,000 meter square. This is a standard relationship. But in the question, how much I have? 100. So 100 centimeter square will be how much? 100 into 1 by 10,000. 1 centimeter square is 1 by 1000. 1 centimeter square is 1 by 10,000. So 100 centimeter square will be how much? 100 into 1 by 10,000. Now you cancel. You get how much? 1 by 100 meter square. So 1 centimeter square is 1 by 10,000 meter square. So 100 centimeter square will be 1 by 100 meter square. Just multiply. 1 is this much, so 100 will be how much? Simple unitary method. Now this area which was 100 centimeter square, that is nothing but 1 by 100 meter square. So you convert the centimeter square into meter square. Now you can get the answer. Now pressure and area is related by what formula? I told you every sum in a physics is related, every question numerical in a physics is related to a particular formula. So what formula is there? There is only one of a formula. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. This is the only formula that we have for this pressure part. So use this formula. Pressure, do I know? Yes, I know. Is how much? 26500. Do I know the thrust or the force? No, I don't know the thrust or the force. Thrust force is same. And over here, area is how much? I will take this one. Not the centimeter, I will take the meter square. So 1 by 100 meter square. Now what I will do? Use algebraic expression, cross multiply, this will come to this. So thrust becomes how much? 26500 into 1 by 100. Now see, 0, 0 cancels. It becomes 265. You have written 265. Now think what will be the unit of this. What after this I have to write a unit. What will the unit of this? 265 is what? Thrust. And what is thrust? Thrust is nothing but a kind of force. Thrust is nothing but a kind of force. So over here it will be how much? 26. So force, what is the SI unit of force? Newton. SI unit of force is Newton. So over here thrust is nothing but 265 Newton, which is a very easy way. So I think you understood the second sum. Now, you got this part. Now, if you have happened to understood this sum, now, pressure is equal to 5750 Pascal. Okay? 5750 Pascal. And the area is how much? Area is near about what a number I will give. Say 20 centimeter square. Okay, this is my the pressure, this is the area, and I want you to give my thrust. Thrust, how much will be the thrust? Write the answer. Achha, let me put one more zero. Okay, let me put one more zero. So now tell me how much is the thrust. So I've changed the numbers and I want you to write the answer in the comment section. So you can take a screenshot. You can take a screenshot right now. Pause the video and take a screenshot. And after you watch the whole video, see the screenshots, solve the sum and write it, the answers in the comment section. Okay, so you do this sum for your homework. Next question. Suppose in a question it is given force as say 250 Newton and pressure is given as area will be, say I'm just thinking something which can divide. This is a very big amount. So say it is nothing but 75000 Pascal. Now suppose this is a question and you're asked to find the area this time, and you have to find the area in centimeter square. You have to find the area not in meter square, in centimeter square. So this is one question. Now see, force, pressure, area is related by what formula? This formula only, there is no other formula. Now force is an SI unit. Yes, the force is an SI unit because Newton is the SI unit. We know Newton hota hai SI unit. Newton is a SI unit. The pressure is, the pressure is an SI unit. Yes, Pascal is a SI unit. Newton per meter square and Pascal are the same thing. So Pascal is also a SI unit. So if Newton is a SI unit and Pascal is a SI unit, and if I happen to put the force over here in place of thrust, I put, because thrust and force are same thing, na? If I write thrust also, that doesn't make any difference. So thrust, if I put it over here, and pressure, if I put it over here, I'll get the area or not? I'll get the area. But in what unit I'll get the area? Think. Force is an SI unit. Pressure is an SI unit. So the area that I will get, that will be also in SI unit only. So I'll get the answer of area, not in centimeter square. In meter square. Why? Because the SI unit, because the SI unit of area is meter square, I told you. So if I happen to solve these two numbers, I'll get the answer of area, but the answer of area that I'll get in meter square, that is the SI unit. But in the question, they have asked to give the answer in centimeter square. So what I will do, I'll find the area in SI unit only. Let's find the area. Whatever unit, SI unit only comes, let's find it. Then we will convert. So we know pressure is equal to force into it. Pressure is equal to, I've already written, pressure is equal to thrust by area. So pressure is how much? 75000. Thrust is how much? 250. And area is how much? I don't know. So I'll put the values. Now try to rearrange. So area becomes how much? Area goes this side and this comes this side. It becomes 250 by 75000. Now if you cancel 00 and it becomes how much? If you cancel quite nicely, now it becomes 1 by 300. Think, 25 will cut 3 times and this 00, so 300. So area becomes 1 by 300. But what is the unit of this? I told you, this is SI unit, this is also SI unit. So area will also come in the SI unit only. And if the area comes in the SI unit, what is the SI unit of area? SI unit of area is meter square that I already told you. So I got the area in meter square, but incidentally the question is asking the answer not in meter square but in centimeter square. So how am I supposed to do that? So I'm rubbing this part so you understand. So I got the area, but I need the area to be in centimeter square because the question wanted it. So I have to convert this 1 by 300 meter square into centimeter square. So how will I convert? Because now I will use this formula. I know 1 meter square is equal to 10,000 centimeter square. I will use this one because over here I am going from meter square to centimeter square. So I will use this formula, not the other one, that previous sum set. Previous formula I used, why? That was centimeter square to meter square. So that is why 1 by 10,000. But over here I am going from meter square to centimeter square. So I will use this formula. So 1 by 300 meter square is this much. How much is centimeter square? So I know 1 meter square is this. So if 1 is this, so 1 by 300 meter square will be how much? Multiply. 1 is this. So 1 by 300 will be how much? 1 by 300 into 10,000. So when you cancel 100 by 3. That will be coming as how much? 33.3 centimeter square. So it will be coming something like this, 33.3. So 1 by 300 meter square is how much? 33.3 centimeter square. So this is the answer. So if you happen to understood this sum, very good. If you happen to understood this sum, good. Then solve this sum. Pressure, thrust or force, whatever. And I do need to find the area. I want the answer of area in centimeter square. So say the thrust is how much? 200 Newton. And pressure is how much? 8,000 Pascal. So I want this question number, I think this is question number 3. So I want this question to be done to by all of you and to write the answer in the comment section. So this is the third question answer I want you to write in the comment section. Use that formula, get the answer of area in meter square, and from meter square you convert that into centimeter square. Okay, how to convert from meter square to centimeter square, just now explained in the previous sum. So I think you can do the sum and give the answer in the comment section. Now, this question. A weight of a girl is 45 kgf. See, kgf, I think I told you. So suppose say, so let's make the sum a little more easy. Say the mass of the girl is 45 kg. Okay, mass of the girl is 45 kg. If the mass of the girl is 45 kg, then what will be the weight? I think you know, 45 kgf, which I already explained in the previous lectures. So if mass is 45 kg, the weight becomes 45 kgf. And the woman is wearing, and the girl is wearing shoe. Okay, the girl is wearing shoe. So over here, one shoe, for one shoe, the area of the shoe, means if I take the sole, okay, huh? If I take the sole, I have to draw a shoe, huh? I am not sure. This is a shoe, okay, in my opinion this is a shoe. So the area of the shoe is how much? 1.5 centimeter into 1 meter. See, this is your book question, but I've changed a little bit because that will be useful for you in the exam. One shoe ka area इट और वन शू का डायमेंशन है, डायमेंशन इज 1.5 इंटू 1 सेंटीमीटर. दिस इज द डायमेंशन ऑफ वन शू. इज टू फाइंड द प्रेशर अप्लाइड बाय द गर्ल. हाउ मच द प्रेशर इज बीइंग अप्लाइड बाय द गर्ल. नाउ one shoe is 1.5 into 1. So if you multiply 1.5 into 1, it becomes how much? 1.5 centimeter square or not? 1.5 into 1 is 1.5 centimeter, centimeter, centimeter square. But a normal girl or a normal person has how many, wears how many shoe?
Two shoes. A normal girl wears two shoes, na?
So if one shoe has this much of area, then two shoe will have how much area? 2 into 1.5 centimeter square, which is equal to 3 centimeter square. Multiply 2 into 1.5, it is 3 centimeter square. So the area of the girl is 3 centimeter square and the weight of the girl is 45 kgf. So you see, now if I happen to see, thrust is given to me. Yes, given to me 45 kgf. Is the area given to me? Yes, given 3 centimeter square total, both shoes area. Now after this one question comes, sir, do I need to convert this kgf into newton and centimeter square into meter square? Do I need to convert both the units into their SI unit? Question is very good, but I will tell you the answer. No, over here for this sum, no need to convert this kgf into newton and centimeter square into meter square. You don't need to convert both of them into your SI unit. Why? Why I don't need to convert? I should convert because that is the standard rule of physics. I need to convert. See, why I will not convert? Because what is the unit right now of thrust? Kgf. Is it a SI unit? No, this is not a SI unit. What is the unit of area? Centimeter square. Is that a SI unit? No, this is not a SI unit. So neither this is a SI unit, neither this is a SI unit. So dono mein se koi bhi SI unit nahi hai. And kgf and centimeter, this kgf unit happens to go with centimeter square unit. Kgf unit happens to go with centimeter square unit. So kgf and centimeter are combined together. So I will not convert over here. I will not convert. Because kgf and centimeter square are not SI unit. And since both of them are not a SI unit and kgf and centimeter forms their own unit, like newton and meter square forms their newton meter square, over here kgf and centimeter square forms their own unit, kgf per centimeter square. So I'll keep it in this way. Now I know pressure is equal to what? Thrust by area. Thrust by area. So just put the formula. Put it. 45 kgf by 3 centimeter square. What it becomes? 15. 45 divided by 3 is 15. Now what about the unit? The unit will be simple. Kgf per centimeter square. So the unit is simple. 15 kgf per centimeter square. So this is the answer. 15 kgf per centimeter square. This is also a unit. Suppose somebody happens to know the answer in SI unit. Then you can do. Suppose somebody wants the answer to be in SI unit, then what you can do? Convert this into newton. 45 kgf is how much newton? 450 newton, because I have taught you 1 kgf is 10 newton, so 45 kgf will be 450 newton. How much this in meter square? 3 centimeter square, it becomes 3 by 10,000 meter square. So if you convert centimeter square into meter square, it becomes 3 by 10,000, which I have done in the previous two sums. Now use this. Pressure is equal to force by area. So force means how much? 450 3 by 10,000. If you solve it, it becomes how much? 150 and again followed by 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4 pascals. Okay, so this is the answer in SI unit. And in kgf per centimeter square, it becomes how much? 15 kgf per centimeter square. So, if you want the answer in SI unit, then this is the answer. If you want to keep the answer in kgf per centimeter square, this is the answer. Okay, I think you understood. If you haven't, read, just do the sum once more. So this is question is very clear. Now, after this, so I have given you, I think, three sums for your homework. So I've given three sums for homework. I need you to do those three sums. And please do the sums. I'm getting some responses, but not from all the students. So do the sums, and that will happen to I will also feel that yes, students do want to study, and they are really interested to watch my videos. So that will definitely motivate me to make other videos. So please do answer the three questions. Even if it is wrong also, but still try it. Okay. Watch the video once more and try it. The relationship between meter square and centimeter square, that is the most important thing for these numericals. That I told you to take the screenshot of the first screenshot. Okay, that is a very important relationship from this aspect. So do the sums and stay safe, stay good. And if you enjoy this video, please give a like, and doubts, write in the comment section. And please, if you haven't yet subscribed, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Can you see the red button down below? Huh? That red button, just press it once. Just close your eyes and press it. Okay? And you will get the notification of all the upcoming videos. So do that for me. And bye. Take care.